Good morning. Reproductive system. It is divided into male reproductive system and female reproductive system. Male reproductive system. The parts of male reproductive system is divided into external parts and internal parts. The external parts include scrotum, testes, epididymis and spermatic cord. The internal parts include vas deferens, seminal vesicle, ejaculatory duct, prostate gland and bulbourethral gland. So these are the parts of male reproductive system. Scrotum. What is scrotum? It is a sac-like or bag-like structure which encloses and protects the testes. Layers of scrotum. Number one, skin. Number two, daughter's muscle. Number three, external spermatic fascia. Number four, cremastic muscle and fascia. Number five, internal spermatic fascia. These are the layers which constitutes the thickness of the scrotum. The daughter's muscle is responsible for the stretching and shrinking of the skin of the scrotum. The function of the scrotum is to maintain moderate temperature for the testes, because the sperm should be produced only in the moderate temperature. Nerve supply. Genital branch of genitofemoral nerve and ilioinguinal nerve. Testis. What is testis? It is a pair, male gonads, suspended in the scrotum. The left testis is somewhat lower than the level of right testis. Parts. It has two ends or poles, upper pole, lower pole. Two borders, anterior border, posterior border. Two surfaces, medial surface, lateral surface. So these are the general features or the external features of the testis. Structure of testis. It has an outer covering which is made up of three layers: tunica vaginalis, tunica albuginea and tunica vasculosa. From the tunica albuginea, numerous septa invades the testes, thus dividing the testes into 200 to 300 lobules. So there are 200 to 300 lobules. Each lobe has one or two seminiferous tubule. Each lobe has one or two seminiferous tubules. So this is the site of center or place where the sperms are produced. The posterior end of the seminiferous tubules becomes straight, forming the straight tubules. All the straight tubules unite to form a network known as reed testes. From the upper end of the reed testis, 18 to 20 different duct arises. They join to form a coiling structure known as epididymis. Depending upon the coiling nature, the epididymis is divided into head, body, and tail. So the epididymis consists of head, body, and tail. Near the tail end of the epididymis, the coiling nature gradually decreases and continues as vas deferens or the ductus deferens. So this is the structure of testes. Blood supply, right and left testicular artery, venous drainage, pampiniform plexus of veins drains the testes. Spermatic cord, it is a tubular structure or cord-like structure that pass to and fro from the testes through the inguinal canal. Layers of the spermatic cord. It consists of three layers. That is a fascia covering the spermatic cord. Number one, external spermatic fascia. Number two, cremastic fascia. Number three, internal spermatic fascia. Contents of spermatic cord. Number one, vas deferens or the ductus deferens. Number two, artery to the vas deferens. Artery to the vas deferens. Number three, genital branch of genitofemoral nerve. Number four, remains of processus vaginalis. Number five, testicular artery. And number six, pampiniform plexus of veins. So these are the contents of spermatic cord. Prostate gland. It is a pyramidal shape, fibromuscular glandular organ. Fibromuscular glandular organ. Present surrounding the prostatic urethra, that is the part of the urethra which is surrounded by the prostate gland. Okay, surrounding the prostatic urethra. Parts. It has an apex, a base, and four surfaces, anterior, posterior, and two inferior lateral surfaces. Lobes. It consists of five lobes. Number one, anterior lobe. Number two, posterior lobe. Number three, median lobe. And two lateral lobes. So there are totally five lobes. Supports of the prostate gland. It is supported by urogenital diaphragm. Number two, puboprostatic ligament. Structure. It is made up of fibrous tissue, muscular tissue, and glandular tissue. Fibrous tissue, it forms the 1/4 of the gland. Muscular tissue, it forms the 1/4 of the gland. Glandular tissue, it forms the half of the gland. So it is made up of three structures. Blood supply. Internal pudendal arteries. Nerve supply. Pelvic splanchnic nerves. The median lobe of the prostate gland is mostly affected in the prostate cancer.